Hafizah to lil ghaibi bima hafizullah. The wives are those who are guarding the husbands in the husband's absence, what Allah would have them guard. Hafizat are those who are doing what? Hafazwat. Hafaza, protect, guard. They protect or guard what? His valuable, his precious, his dear, his near belongings. When? In his absence, when he's not around. So what would need to be protected by the wife? What would she need to guide? His honor and her own honor. His bed, his secrets, his money, his wealth, the environment of his house, his children, and last but not the least, his dear, old, sick, weak parents, his mother, his beloved father. Looking after and caring for his parents is what Salihat, Qanitat, Hafizat is expected to do. It is her duty. She is duty bound. I today hear of so many religious scholars talking and saying and dividing parents and very clearly announcing that his parents are for him to look after and her parents are for her to look after. Nauzubillah. How do we deprive and how do we misguide? What sort of a swaliha? What sort of a qanita? What sort of a hafiza wife is she going to be? How can she be a righteous woman? How can she be an obedient person of the Allah, an obedient wife of the husband? And how can she be a guarding wife of the husband if she is not looking after these muhsineen, these nearest and dearest relations of her husband? Obviously, if she is a swaliha, she is a righteous, pious, virtuous woman, she's not expected to do that. And all husbands of qanitat are obviously expecting and obviously guiding and obviously instructing the wives to look after their parents. And this, no doubt, is the dearest and the nearest and the most valuable belonging of the husband which he is leaving behind in the house. And then why? Why does he have to leave them behind? Obviously, to be able to go out, to earn for whom? To earn for her. To be able to provide for her. To be able to feed her. To be able to clothe her. To be able to fend and fetch for her children and the family. So if he is having to go out and leave his sick parents, his dear mother, his beloved father in the house dependent on her, then being a saliha, being a qanita, being a hafiza, she is duty bound. It is her duty. It is not only her duty. It is her privilege. It is a blessing. It is a rahmah. And do we divide rahma? Parents, how can we divide them? Allah has been so very kind that if before marriage we just had two gates to paradise, two feet, two souls under where we had our paradise, after marriage they will multiply to four. Who is going to divide your rahma? How can we say for you are your parents and for me are my parents? And how can we say and how can we instruct the Muslim women that you are not supposed and you're not duty bound to look after your parents, not duty bound to look after his parents and your mother-in-law and your father-in-law? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make us one of those. Make us one of those wives who accept, who realize, and who are dutiful. Rabbana hablana min azwajina wa zurriyatina qurrata ayunin waj'alna lil muttaqina imama. O Allah, make our husbands in our children the coolness of our eyes and make us the leaders of the God-fearing. Make us the imam of the muttaqeen. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم.